Hello, hello. This is Renat Gorin, an artist from the Bay Area, California. I want to give you tour number four of my studio today. And as you can see, my studio is full of packaged art. Some art is going out, some art is coming back in, and there's a lot of organization going on here. What I'd like to show you today is this one large piece that I'm going to tell you about. This piece is 60 by 60. It's made out of four panels that are 30 by 30. And it's encaustic, just like the rest of my practice, which means a lot of layers of beeswax with pigments. And the piece was made when I came back from Japan. I was so impressed with the Japanese aesthetics, which shows everywhere in their streets, in their buildings, in their homes, in their gardens, in their clothes, in their products, of course. Just beautiful, simple lines. The first thing you can see is the blue indigo that I don't usually use in my art. Usually my art is more red and yellow and orange. But when you come back from Japan, you know, the indigo blue just catches your soul and you can't ignore it. It's so beautiful. So, of course, it jumped into my art too. And this piece is actually about the Japanese language, or more specifically, a dictionary that I was introduced to that was Japanese English. It's hard to make a dictionary from Japanese to English because Japanese language doesn't have alphabetical order or alphabet. Someone brilliant was thinking of organizing the symbols by the way they're written. So the whole dictionary is divided into sections of squares like these. And depends on how the symbol is written, where it's completely full, where it's written from right to left or top to bottom. That's how the dictionary is organized. I just thought it's really brilliant and I love the idea. And that's the result. This piece is called Hidden Language. And it is, again, as I said, 60 by 60. And that will be it for today. Next time I will show you something new. See you. Bye.